Welcome back to Let's Play The Wolf Among Us Blind. I am the RPG chick, Amethyst Lotari. The achievements are the only thing. I think the only achievements we get is just for finishing. Unlock all Book of Fables. Right, completing chapters. Unfortunately, not getting all the entries. I guess there's hidden entries. Like, that are a little harder to get to, because we don't have this one. And we don't have the... yeah, the other one. Alright. Beginning! Episode 3. A Crooked Mile.
Our stories used to be so simple. We had a beginning, a middle, and an end.
It's him.
But ever since we moved to this awful city, everything's gotten so confused.
Look, I didn't kill anyone.
And I'm supposed to just believe you. Snow. I just want you to be careful. I almost lost you once, and...
I'm not yours to lose. I'm not going to be an errand girl for Crane anymore.
She looks
go,
like
girl.
Holly.
It's not Holly. It's her sister, Lily.
She was hooking to pay down debt.
Saying all trolls
eventually
look alike.
The only people she owed were at her work.
My name is Nerissa.
I had to take on another part.
Well, Nerissa, I've got some questions. The open arms.
Oh my God! What is it?
It's Crane.
Yep, and he saw us in the mirror and then broke it. They left that part out. So Ichabod Crane was the one. But I don't know if he's the one who killed Faith. Frickin' Crane.
Fucking creep. Spineless little fucking rat.
Crane? Ugh. God, you think you'd know a person.
He's nasty.
You have to tell her.
I know.
What's going on? What did you find up there? You know, other than the...
I need to find Snow.
Just need to find Snow.
Why? What's going on?
A lot.
Shit!
Crane's been... Oh, Bigby, calm down. Everything's going to be fine, okay? It's going to be fine.
Will someone please explain this to me?
Snow is in danger.
Crane has been stalking Snow White.
Perverted little fucker might be after Snow. I need to find her right now.
Okay, it's going to be okay. Where did you see her last? Did she say where she was going?
She took Holly to the business office to prepare for the funeral.
Lily's funeral?
She's yeah. There.
How do you know?
I was just at the Trip Trap, and I heard Gren telling some folks about a funeral at the Buckingham
the
Bridge.
The Trip Trap? Are you drinking?
When?
Right now. They were on their way out.
Bigby! Wait.
If he's drinking, it's because she kept, like, disappearing on him.
What?
And he
Snow's,
didn't know why.
Snow's been through a lot. There are things she doesn't talk about. Just please be careful when you tell her. And you should tell her. But...
What do you mean?
What are you trying to say?
You know how you felt when you saw that picture? Well, it's going to be much worse for her. Just remember that.
When she sees the picture. I thought he meant... I thought she meant what would happen to her if Crane got a hold of her would be much worse. The Buckingham Bridge, 10:28 p.m. There's that same sign on all of them. Alright, I had safety glasses, vest required at all times. There's a lot of candles. Money. Yeah, I forgot. We took money from... what's his name? Tweedledee.
you by claiming one day that the pain of losing Lily will ever subside. I know as well as you that it will never subside.
What's going on?
Who's but I this? Also know that the memory of Lily will sustain as well. And it will,
Weaver
in
over.
Time, equal in strength to our mourning her loss.
Oh, it's the funeral. I'm not waving.
And it is in that spirit that I'd like to talk about what you've all been so grateful to share with me. Your memories of her. How she could be stubborn
she
and
just wait a second.
Patient, rash
Let's
and
look
thoughtful.
At the table here.
How she carried a torch for the old ways, for tradition, for
card
pageantry. And most of all, it seems how
I'll miss worrying
Lily
about
loved,
you. I'll miss our fights.
Her friends
I'll
and
miss
friends.
You.
She Holly. Loved being around them, in good times and bad. I never met Lily.
This card.
What I've been told. I know in
now
my
you
heart
will never die from indifference
to
or lead a tedious
and
life.
Now we'll have our
goodbye, sweetheart.
Moment of silence.
Thanks for everything.
Thank you.
Vivian.
Who's Vivian?
You were a big, bright, shining star in this shithole of a town. And I miss you already. Gran.
Iggy, is everything okay?
Not really.
No, not you.
Yep, me.
Holly, it's...
He wasn't fucking invited.
I'm not
Holly,
here for that.
Wait.
He has no right to be here. Not after what he did.
I don't want trouble.
Look, Holly, I'm not here to start trouble.
You throw my sister down the witching well, and you have the nerve to show your face here. After you lie and say you'll check first.
I didn't throw her down there.
Holly, wait. That was Crane. Just Crane. He disposed of Lily's body before Bigby could do anything about it.
Right.
I'm telling you the truth.
Don't cover for him.
But this genuinely wasn't his fault.
You can't tell me Bigby gives a shit about this. Holly, it's gonna be okay.
Maybe that's Vivian? Crane's a jerk.
Crane's a fucking prick, so this doesn't surprise me.
Hey, what do you know? We actually agree on something.
Bigby cares, Holly. He's trying to help. And I'm sure he has a very good reason for being here.
Yeah, I haven't had a chance.
This one isn't on him.
Why are you here anyway? And don't say it's because you care about this.
Everything okay?
I think I know who murdered your sister, by the way.
I think I know who murdered your sister.
Who?
Maybe we should talk about this somewhere else.
What? No, I deserve to know.
I know.
Why not? Just say it here.
I know, but this isn't the way to go about this.
I don't give a fuck about the way. I don't care about procedure. If anyone should be told, it's me. It's us. Right now. So talk.
I need to talk to Snow.
Who was it? I came here to talk to Snow about this.
No, screw that. My sister's dead, and I don't give a shit who she looked like when it happened. It's not about her. It's about Lily.
Just tell us who it was.
Okay, everyone, just stop. Bigby and I are going to have a little chat while everyone else gets back to the funeral.
Saved by the snow.
What? I'm not just gonna sit here
Please,
and...
I promise I will tell you what the hell is going on just as soon as I know there's something to tell, but just let us do our jobs first.
Besides, you're not sitting. You're standing.
Look, Holly, I know how this must...
No, you don't know how this must feel. You have no idea. Don't fuck anything up. Don't bother anybody. And when the first sign of trouble comes, and it will come because you're a goddamn walking trap for it, I want you the fuck out of here. You hear me?
I just want Lily's killer.
I just want to get Lily's killer, Holly. Nothing more.
Let's just continue, okay?
This is such total fucking bullshit.
Let's go, Holly.
It's your turn to talk.
Okay, you think you know who the killer is. What have you got? Bigby?
Crane murdered Lily.
What's going on?
Crane murdered Lily.
What?
I followed a lead to this shithole motel, the Open Arms. Crane had a room there, and he's been taking prostitutes, or at the very least Lily, and making her look like you while he was, you know. The bed was covered in blood. I know it was him.
This is... I don't even know what to say right now. I really don't. I'm just trying everything I can right now to not picture it. To not picture him.
I'm sorry, Snow. And I'm sorry I had to be the one to tell you.
You're sure this is what happened? This is what he's been doing? Because please, Bigby, don't confuse things. Opposing Crane would be the next step. And if we get this wrong, it would mean more than our jobs.
He took photos.
We'd get kicked out of Fabletown for messing all of this up so badly.
Crane has been taking photos, Snow. Lots of photos.
Photos that show him...
He's been recording his visits with Lily.
Wasn't just going to show her the photo.
Look, let's go back to the business office. I doubt Crane's there at this hour, but we need to talk. And this isn't the place. Snow?
Might
Narissa?
Be watch. No, he broke
what
the mirror.
It? I'm sorry, but Holly's asking for you. Are they starting the burn? Yes. Everyone who spoke should really be present for this part. She's kind of distraught. You're not leaving yet, are you?
Mm.
2 minutes. I don't mean to be, No, I understand. It's just that something's come up.
You okay?
Are you okay? You don't have to do this right now.
I'll be fine. How'd it go at the motel?
So that, I just want to say I was confused. Oh, we got some entries too. I can look at that. I was confused because the original Little Mermaid story, I believe, is by Hans Christian Andersen. And in that story, I looked it up. She doesn't have a name. The Little Mermaid does not have a name. And it's a lot darker story. I'm not going to really get into it, but... Yeah, the whole thing about when she walks around, she feels like it's like knives, you know, into her feet and I guess legs as well. That's gotta be tough and gotta be hard to dance on a stage when you're feeling knives. So, Narissa, apparently the name was just made up by Telltale for this, because unless for the Fables. Comic. Alright, we got one entry. Troll funeral rites. Oh, okay, so they got their own little customs, I see, as I had gathered. The gaze of Mother Death is always upon us. Beneath her affectionate eye, we fight our battles. We nurse our wounds. We shout our victories. We endure our sorrows. And when we fall, she is there. Her embrace is the silence of the mountain, the heavy peace of the stone, approximately translated. A troll funeral is a sacred ritual passed down by oral traditions from troll mother to son. It begins at sunset with the creation of the cairn, a small pile of stones to represent the many generations of trolls that have traveled and died before them, the foundation upon which the living stand. Weapons are divided amongst the trolls' closest comrades. The body and the rest of their possessions are burned, and though each viewer must speak to the life of the lost, the eulogy's candor would make a Mundy blush. Now that's from 2. All right.
Did you find anything?
Yeah,
no.
It was Crane's room.
It was Crane's room. But you knew that already, right?
Narissa!
Yeah, coming!
Another entry. Vivian. Okay, Georgie's girl. Much of Vivian's past is unknown since she prefers not to talk about her life back in the homelands. She wanted to start fresh in Fabletown, but she finds herself working for Georgie at the Pudding and Pie. It's not a terrible life. Georgie took a liking to Vivian, so he doesn't make her take jobs at the open arms. Instead, she plays hostess and helps Georgie ensure complete customer satisfaction. Alright, she's the one who greeted us. Okay, so that's Vivian. I don't know if she's a Fable-like character that we would know from Fables.
Constable?
Wait,
easy now, girl.
Not you again.
You know how this goes. Oh. The first thing in a visit...
Both of them.
You say, how do you do? How do you do?
You're about to regret
that
this.
Way, it's proper.
I'd tell you to run, but it won't do any good. Just make it more fun for me.
What are you dreaming about? You ain't a fast enough pup to prevent me from emptying both barrels into Snow White's face over there. We'll snip to the chase for all sakes. A little bird told us that you're fitting to go after Crane. And you see, we have an interest in that particular boy.
Was that
so
his
leave
boss?
Crane alone, and we'll leave you alone.
He's the one
just
hired him.
Just take a little vacation is all.
You
don't
work,
even have to go anywhere.
You work for Crane.
Just sit in your office and whistle to heaven for a few short days.
Are you working for Crane? Did he send you?
No, see now, you're already asking too many questions. Just pay attention. So what's it gonna be? We have a deal? You leave Crane alone, and we leave you to yours?
If I just lie?
Brother, speak your mind. Fastly now. What's it gonna be?
Just don't hurt anyone.
Just don't hurt anyone, Dee.
That don't sound like a yes to me. Always wanting to do things the fun way.
Ladies, gentlemen, invertebrates, please, rest easy. This is not...
What the hell is going on?
What's happening?
Very sorry to impose, but we only had a deal to work out with Bigby. And we're unhappy to report that things did not go as smoothly as planned.
Someone's gonna die
Bigby?
Now.
What
really?
Is he talking about?
Never you mind that. It ain't any of your...
What deal?
Settle down now. Yeah, everyone just stay where you are, nice and natural, like we're just out having a spring
picnic.
Do you
stop this crap?
Stop this shit. Right. Now.
He hasn't exactly been a good sport about this. Not making our lives any easier.
Oh, here we go.
I'll tell you. What did I say?
Ollie?
Think you motherfuckers could come here uninvited? You think you could just fucking interrupt Lily's funeral?
Calm down, darling. It was just a simple business transaction.
You fucking freaks are not getting away with this.
Holly, don't move.
I'll handle this.
Listen to your lady, love.
Holly, let me handle this.
Yeah, let's spare all the fuss. It's just a dead hole.
Oh, now you gotta
say
that.
I'm gonna kill you!
No one else is gonna die here tonight. Oh, maybe someone else is gonna die. Oh, maybe I'm gonna die. Fables are hard to kill, though. Fables are hard to kill. That just won't. That won't kill her by just that. You gotta like overdose on medicine while shooting yourself in the head and stabbing yourself in order to die. That's ridiculous. So I just want to apologize, guys, if there's any like nudity like last episode. I have to like take out those frames, I'm sorry. Which takes out the sound as well, of course. Sorry about that. I can't put it up on YouTube like that. I could get a strike on my channel, and that's not worth it. So, I hope you understand. Episode 3, A Crooked Mile. I already had to take out part of the recap from the beginning of this episode. The recap of last episode. Fabletown Business Office, the Woodland Building, 11:43 p.m.
I did as well as I could to take out the buckshot, but there's still some shards left embedded in your shoulder. They'll eventually worm their way out on their own, but until they do, you're going to be sore.
Bigby, Dr. Swinehart was appointed Fabletown physician for a reason.
It's okay. There's only one thing you have to take away from all this. Take it easy.
Good luck.
Don't go looking for any more fights. Keep strain off your heart. And try and get some rest.
How's everyone else?
How's everyone else? They all make it?
They're fine. I had everyone that got wounded sent home. Holly refused to let me see where she lived. So I left her and Grendel back at her bar with a dose of juniper and spring water.
Holly's alive, okay. So is Grendel.
They're titans, Bigby. They'll be fine. Just remember what I said. The stitches won't hold up if you continue to act like you normally do.
Well, I got three more episodes left.
And eat more chicken. Your blood pressure's through the proverbial roof.
I'll try.
Try to.
All right, then. Very good.
Swinehart?
Business office. I know. I'll have to call you back. The town is starting to find out.
Well, I'll leave you two to it, then.
What are they finding out?
Bigby?
I wonder what the town is finding out. Sorry, guys. By the way, I try not to talk during dialogue, but the whole thing is almost dialogue. And they talk before I realize that they're about to say something. Dr. Swinehart, the army surgeon. Dr. Swinehart is a resident Fabletown physician, so skilled in the art of instrumental surgery that he can safely operate on himself. He served as an army medic for many years, sometimes using his talents to impress the locals. He currently runs the special research section of the Knights of Malta Hospital, so named to discourage people from investigating what is actually a reserved fables-focused health facility. Excuse me.
So, to recap,
Crane watched me through the magic mirror uncover his room at the Open Arms, and then he smashed it so we couldn't use it ourselves to go after him. And we know this because Bufkin was drinking in the rafters. Mm-hmm. That about cover it?
And once he puts all the pieces back together, it'll be easy to catch Crane. So, I guess that's the plan, currently. But I don't know.
We can fix that thing? Just wait for the mirror? Oh, I didn't say anything. Never mind.
What the hell is going on?
Sorry, lost in thought.
I don't know what the Tweedles get out of this. I don't know if Crane sent them. I don't know if... I mean, this is gonna sound crazy, but do you really think Crane did it? Everything points to him. I get it. But do you really think he killed those women? Because it's just... it's incomprehensible.
I think he killed Lily.
What I saw at the Open Arms, everything points to Crane murdering Lily. What isn't adding up for me is faith. Why would he kill her? It doesn't seem connected.
Exactly, yeah, I agree.
It doesn't make sense. He was a conniver, a coward, a liar.
Nasty guy.
I'll always hate him for that. And I'll hate him for how he held me in his thoughts. But murdering prostitutes? Ow! Everything okay over there?
Yes, Miss White. Just cut myself on a piece of the glass. Nothing to worry about.
Thanks for tonight, by the way. That could have gone really terribly. I mean, even worse than it did. I'm glad you were there.
I feel bad for Holly.
I just feel bad for Holly, really.
Yeah. Time heals everything eventually. At least, I hope so, for her sake. Can I, ask you a question?
You just did.
It's kind of personal. And I don't want to offend you, but after tonight, it's on my mind.
What's on your mind?
Why? What's on your mind?
It's just, when stuff hits the fan, like it did tonight, it feels like before we came to the city. It feels kind of like home. And I've heard it said that maybe in some
tiny little bottled up way deep inside, you kind of enjoy it when things go wrong.
Do I?
Because it gives you an excuse to just, you know, stop pretending.
I don't enjoy it.
Fuck no, I don't enjoy it. Are you kidding me? It's horrible what happened tonight. I wish it didn't happen.
I didn't want to say it like that.
I shouldn't have said anything. Forget that I did.
Guys?
They want to say it like that.
What is it?
I can't finish the mirror. It's missing a piece.
Not surprising.
What do you mean, missing a piece?
She means it's actually missing a piece.
It's not here.
Crane must have taken it.
Crane must have taken a shard with him.
Oh, I can't believe this.
I saw Crane pick something up after he smashed it. I'm sorry, I didn't realize what it was until now.
Well, the mirror can't work unless it's whole.
Well, that's not entirely true.
Really? What, Buffkin? What? We sit around and wait until it mends itself? We have no idea how long that will take.
It's got an
We're
idea.
We're just gonna have to do this the hard way.
I'm just saying, waiting is an option.
Oh, waiting?
No. We can't depend on the mirror.
How long will the mirror take?
How long will it take for the mirror to reform?
Well, it could take days.
Or months, or years.
Oh, well.
He had to have left something that tells us where he's going. He's a neat freak, but he was never that smart.
Smart enough to take a piece of the mirror? We can still solve this ourselves. I know
never
that
Never mind that. Come help me look.
You can't just put something else there? You have any other magical glass around that we can just get from somewhere else? I'm gonna talk to him first.
Hi, Mr. Bigby. I can still help you catch Crane, you know.
You can?
Oh, yeah?
Yes. I saw him jump on the telephone before he left. He called up somebody. He said he needed to see his witch, or that he would need to get to the witch for that. Whoever that is.
That redial.
His witch?
Yes, it sounded like the one he got his snow glamours from.
See anything else?
You didn't see anything else, did you?
No, not especially.
Especially? It's not your fault.
Look, the whole mirror thing, it's not your fault, all right?
You mean it?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
I'll just see if I can do anything about this.
You do that.
Alright. Let's see what else we can do before we talk to Snow. I can examine Crane's desk. Well, I got some letters. Ichabod Crane, are there any updates on the extra funding I requested? As I explained in my last letter, the conditions here could do with some improvement. I'm seeing some unrest from the residents, and I have to admit I can see why. The farm should not be a punishment. I'm sure you're busy, but I think this should be made a priority. Best, Wayland Smith. Extra funding for the farm. Okay. She's watching me read stuff. Guess I got a drawer we can open. From Boy Blue? Little Boy Blue? Dear Mr. Ichabod Crane, I'm writing to ask again that you please send someone to fix the air conditioning in our unit. It's burning up in the apartment and Pinocchio says his skin is splintering. Pinocchio, really. I don't know what that means, but I assume it's something gross, and I'd really like it if you'd fix the air like we asked you 3 months ago. At the very least, provide us a fan in the meantime. Sincerely, Boy Blue. Is this from the farm as well? One more. Hopefully it lets us open a drawer after that and look at the phone. Mr. Toad. From Mr. Toad. Mr. Crane, you said you'd pay to have the plaster redone in my building after the last incident in 204. It's falling off the walls. Please fix it. I can't rent out that room as it is, and I've already been waiting for days. Not to mention, you already promised me you'd send someone to fix the big crack in the glass on the front door. Well, guess what? It's worse now. Get your crap together, Mr. Toad.
Did Crane ever do any work?
Only when Cole was around.
Cole, huh? Who's Cole? Nat King Cole? King Cole, eh? Alright, he's been gone for a while. Official compendium of what? The Office of Business Affairs, official compendium of authorized articles. The King
There's
of
a
something.
Page here that was torn out.
The King
oh,
of
yeah?
something.
Bufkin, do you know what was here?
It's a ring, at least. Every magical item not retained in the armory is assigned to someone in Fabletown. It must be this witch he is going to see.
Wait, what witch?
Bufkin overheard Crane set up a meeting with a witch.
Well, yes, it sounded like the one he got his, glamours from. It must be about this ring.
Why not mention this before?
No one asked me.
Bufkin!
He told me.
I'm sorry.
I'm hungover.
He set the meeting at 2 a.m. tonight.
Oh.
What's going on? Is the mirror fixed yet?
Bluebeard, this isn't the time.
Is the mirror fixed or isn't it? You called me to...
I called just to see if you knew where Crane could be, and that was it, okay? And I'm sorry I said anything more than that.
Well, you did, and I know. The cat's out of the bag. So, can we find the dull pervert or not?
I tried
this
to, but...
This isn't your concern.
Should have called you.
I don't know why Snow told you anything.
He and Crane talk all the time, okay? He was a resource, albeit one that turned out to be useless.
We hardly talk all the time. Besides, why spend time on such gutter snipe?
Look, this just isn't the time. He took a piece of the mirror, so we can't use it.
The only thing we know is that Crane's going to see a witch at 2 o'clock.
A.M. or P.M.?
A.M.
Listen, Bluebeard, you're not a part of this.
I don't think you're in any position to turn away help.
Define help.
What do you know about Crane?
What do you know about Crane, anyway?
That he has the stones to kill prostitutes like any common sex-frightened serial killer and not face a real challenge.
Look, we know that Crane is going to see a witch, and it's to acquire a magic ring.
What's the ring?
We don't know what it does or who it's assigned to since Crane tore its page out of the book.
This farce was your ridiculous idea for a plan. Who put you in charge in the first place?
Fixing the mirror was the most logical
You're
thing.
You're a secretary. He's the sheriff. And none of you were chosen to run this office. Who elected you to make these decisions?
Nobody, but that
Who
doesn't...
elected her to spend my money?
Well, I've been doing that unofficially for years.
Snow can handle it.
Not officially.
Snow can obviously handle this, so let's drop it.
Well then, excuse me for having the Commonwealth in mind.
Whatever.
All right, let's just look on the bright side. We know Crane is going to see the witch that's been supplying him black market glamours.
Thanks to me.
And that he'll be there at 2. So that gives us a few short hours to find out who it is and where they live and get them all at once.
And a few shorter hours the more you babble about it.
We haven't been the ones babbling.
Yeah, I'm gonna look.
Just point in the direction you want me to check first.
Since Lily used the glamours, she'd have known who the witch was. And I don't think Holly's burned her things yet. It would probably have the address or a phone number or something.
And Bigby is free to go there if he likes. But I think the question you should be asking is just what do the two Tweedles know about this?
It doesn't matter what they know. After tonight, they'd never go to their office.
They're not smart enough to try and go anywhere else.
The Trip Trap is the better option to track the witch down. That has to be our focus.
Lily's stuff
Lily
may help
has
us.
Lily's things. That'd probably be the safer bet.
I don't really care what you two do. I'm going to his apartment.
What? You can't just go up there.
And why the hell not?
We already looked for the key, remember? I don't know where it is.
Then I'll pick the blasted lock! I've wasted enough time waiting for the mirror to find him. I won't waste any more.
You just can't go up there alone, all right?
I've no interest in nicking his drapes, my dear, if that's what concerns you.
What concerns me is you traipsing through possible evidence.
Oh, now it's evidence. Before you had no interest, and now it's a crime scene.
You're not going anywhere.
You're not going anywhere.
Really now? And what? You gonna stand here and babysit me while the rest of your leads evaporate into mist?
We have to find the witch, Bluebeard, since that's where he's going.
Or the sniveling weasel chickened out. Never went anywhere. And is upstairs right now in his pitiful penthouse, crafting a fort out of couch cushions. Look, this is how a smart person would do it. So this is how we're going to do it. Wherever you go, I'll go to the other.
I don't like you going anywhere unsupervised. He's up to something. I don't know what it is, but we don't have the time to really worry about it now.
I wonder where his loyalties lie.
Where are you gonna go, Bigby?
Here comes the choice, doesn't it? Find the witch.
See, so what? You leave Crane alone, and we'll leave you alone.
I'd love to join you, but there's some business I need to attend to.
No, I'm better off dealing with things alone. I don't need sympathy and I don't need charity.